I went into the bathroom by myself, locked the door, and I like looked in the mirror and I was like, okay, I'm bald. And it was actually very natural. It didn't feel strange at all. It was just like, I feel like I just don't have any hair.
I feel like we were so prepared for it that it wasn't really a shock, because it's been like 3 months and we were like ready to be bald.
Yeah.
We went and looked in the mirror together for the first time about an hour later, which was funny. We were just like, interesting.
Like good interesting or bad interesting?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't recognize myself really, and she didn't either. I thought she looked really good, and she thought I looked really good, but for like ourselves, we were both like, I don't know, I think I liked me with hair better.
So, Jenny and I didn't look at ourselves for about an hour afterwards, because it felt great. Like, it immediately felt good, and everyone was like, you look great, you look so good, blah, blah. We hadn't seen any pictures, and we hadn't looked in the mirror yet, so we decided that we needed to do this. So we went into the bathroom, and we held hands, and we turned around, and it was okay.
A little shocking.
Yeah, but it was all right. Yeah.
Then what happened?
It wasn't as bad as I was expecting, so it was good.
During the shaving, we had long hair, so they like cut our braids off and then they handed it to you. And at one point, my mom was like, "Oh, Jenny, hold my hair." So I was sitting there, like shaving my head, and I was holding my hair, and then I was a little shocked because I was looking at my hair. My mom's picture.
Yeah, when they hand it to you, it's a little shocking.
My immediate reaction is I stood up and screamed, like really excited, and then like the next 20 minutes, I just stood there like. Going like this, like feeling my head.
I know. I know.
I had an idea to auction off my hair for a week. I mean, basically, I held a head auction. I invited a bunch of people to like, come over and shave my head however they wanted to, and I'd wear it for a week with no hats and no dignity to raise money for this fund, and my head went for $111. Anyway, I sent out an email to my family to tell mom doing, and hopefully they could circulate that around their friends, and my dad did. And so his friend said, hey, I give $50 to see you shave your head. And a bunch of his old fraternity brothers and lacrosse buddies decided to join as well, and they still have the sadistic tendencies that my fraternity brothers do. So he decided that he'd shave his head as well. And so he's shaving his head too, and I think he'll get about $300. And we joined him to our team last night.
He's on our team. So
he came for the UVA Maryland lacrosse game that Saturday, and a bunch of his old friends from college were there, and they had said that they were going to donate 50 or 20 or 25 if he shaved his head, not until. And so we shaved his head at the tailgate with a pair of clippers that we plugged into the car, and now he has a bald head, which he hasn't had since he enlisted in the military.
And he looks great.
He does look good.
He looks good.
So, yeah. looks younger.
Yeah.
Kind of weird.
It's a generational thing too. I think both Emily and my parents and a lot of adults were really shocked. It felt really shocking and appalling because women being bald is not something that has been socially acceptable for very long at all, if it's acceptable now. And I think Emily put it in such a great way. Half the purpose of shaving your head in solidarity with these kids who have cancer is to show that bald isn't freaky, it isn't ugly, it's not abnormal. It's a type of beauty in its own, and it's something that I'm excited to embrace.
I have lots of male friends who I've tried to convince to shave with me, and they are more attached to their hair than I am. So
I guess my hair has really sparked a lot of questions about why it's like this.
It
right
says
now.
Tool on the back.
Yeah,
Lucas, turn.
You can't see it?
Right.
Yeah. So they always ask, why is your hair like that? Do you lose a bet or are you pledging in a fraternity? And I say, no, I'm actually doing this fundraiser. And suddenly they're like, oh yeah, it's great. I'd give you money if I had any with me. But either way, they're supporting it. And so
I'm just scared because I don't know what's underneath everything. You know, I don't know if I have like a dent or a bump or a crevice or a weird spot or mole or whatever it may be. But it's also you're giving away a year, you've grown your hair out for a year, and it's like a part of you is just going to be gone, and within, essentially a minute. You spend a year growing it, and in 1 minute, it's all gone. So some people don't recognize me, because when you go from having 11 and a half inches on your head to having just above a centimeter, people don't really know how to react. They say, why'd you do it? And I explain it to them. But everything's been really positive. They said that it looks good. I don't have any ridges or bumps or anything, so it's always nice to hear. But so far, everyone's just acted really supportive, and they've really loved it, and they rub it.
It's nice to have people rub your head all the time.
A guy recently got my number and we went out for a date on Sunday night, and I knew that if I was having a lot of fun, it was going to be a little difficult to tell him that I'm not going to have any hair soon. And I had so much fun, and so I didn't tell him that I'm going bald. And I was trying to find out ways that I could like encounter him again, because I didn't want to be too forward and call him for a second date so that I could tell him I'm going to be bald. But I just feel like he might need a little warning so that he doesn't, pick me up for our second date and I have no hair. Shockingly.
Just call him, tell him to hang up. And if he calls back, then he's a keeper. And if he doesn't...
Well, I was thinking of actually just inviting him to the Baldrick's event and being like, hey, so a bunch of my friends, we're going to be hanging out.
Watch me shave my head.
At Boylan Heights on Thursday night. It's going to be really fun. You should come. And then, voila, he would find out, I guess.
I think you should ease him into it. I mean, just finding out like that, should be like, all right, I'm leaving.
Well, I'm hoping that he'll just think it's really cool.
And sexy.
And yeah, really hot.
Maybe
he'll donate towards it. Maybe he'll shave his head too.
On the spot.
Does he have nice hair?